Hi, hello. We are going to install QRadar Community Edition in an Amazon Web Services EC2 instance. And this is the process that we are going to follow. We have to download QRadar Community Edition. We have to download and install VMware Workstation Pro Trial. We have to change the root password of the original virtual machine from IBM. We have to upload the OVA file to Amazon Web Services S3, configure the Amazon Web Services roles and policies in order to do the next step, that is import OVA file and convert it in an Amazon machine image. This will allow us to create an EC2 instance and then run the QRadar installation. And at the end, after installing and when we have running QRadar Community Edition, we will have to patch it because the current version you can download from the official IBM site is not able to work as you download it. You have to patch. It needs two fixes that I will explain it at the end. But the most important thing, the most important of this video, is not to know how to install QRadar in general or how to use QRadar. The main reason because I do this video is to explain how to make it run in Amazon Web Services. And these are the steps that we have to follow. Just an important notice before continuing. You will need an Amazon Web Service account. If you don't have one, you need it. We are not going to explain how to create an Amazon Web Service account. Yeah, in the same way that we are not going to explain how to download a file, how to install VMware Workstation, we are going to go step by step following the step that we required to make all of this work together. But if you are trying to make run QRadar in Amazon Web Services, I guess that it's because you know what's Amazon Web Service, you know to create an account, you know how to download and install a program. So if you agree with this, let's go to the first step. The first step is to download the OVA file of QRadar. So go to the IBM official site of the Security QRadar Community Edition and download it. Next step is to download and install VMware Workstation Pro. There is a trial version that is valid for 1 month and we are going to use it for 10 minutes, so it's okay. Download the trial version, install it, and we go to the next step. Once we have downloaded the OVA file and we have downloaded and installed the VMware Workstation Pro, we have to create the virtual machine this way. We can now start the virtual machine and follow the standard installation process. The first step is to create a new password for the root user. That's what we are going to do now. And that's all that we are going to do. After set the password for the root user, we shut down the machine. The next step is to create a new OVA file and we will upload it to Amazon. Now we have to upload the new file to the S3 service in Amazon. To do that, you have to go to your Amazon Web Service site and in the top of the page, there is a text box where you can write S3 and then appears the list of services. Then you have to choose S3. If you have no files in the S3, you will see a page like this and you have to choose create a bucket. But if you have other buckets, so if you have already files in S3, then the page will be different, but the option is the same. You have to choose anyway, create a bucket. The name of the bucket is not important. You can choose any one you want. But what is very important is the region. I don't mind which one you choose, but you have to choose the same region during the whole process. Which one to choose? I don't know. It depends on your priorities. I have selected EU Ireland EU West 1 because it's the cheapest option and it's very close to me because I am in Spain, so the latency will be good enough and the price will be the minimum. Once you have created the bucket, you have to create a new folder. It's very important that the name of the folder starts with migration-hub-orchestrator-vmie-, anything you want. Now we can upload to this folder the OVA file that we have created. Now the file is uploaded and it is available in the S3 service. What we have to do is to get the address up to the file because we will need it later. Copy it and paste in somewhere you want because we will need it later. Before we can run the process to convert the OVA file to a virtual machine image, we must create the role and the policy to authorize the process. To do that, look at the top right of the page and click on your ID. A menu will be displayed and you must enter in security credentials. We have to access to the roles option and we create a new role with these options: AWS Service, EC2, Next, and Next again. We create the role name. This is very important. The role name has to be exactly this, VM import. And we are going to edit the permissions. We create a policy and this will open a new tab. Look that, there are two tabs now. We create the new policy and we press in JSON and paste the text that I will give you in the comments. This is the new rule and we have to replace this that, as you can see, you can read bucket. We have to change this with the name of the bucket that you have created. I put it here and now we have authorized this role to access to our S3 folder. Create the policy name. In this case, I call it EC2 policy. Create the policy. And now we go back to the first tab and the policy is not here. So we have to refresh it and we find the policy. We chose it, press next. This way we have linked the policy to the role. We are going to create the role. Once the role is created, we are going to access it again and push or click in the trust relationships. And we edit the trust policy and again we paste the text. Update the policy, and that's all. Now we are ready to launch the process. We write here migrate, AWS Migration Hub appears, we click on it, orchestrate, get start. We are going to create a new migration workflow. We choose this one, import virtual machine image to AWS. We select and press next. We just have to introduce here the name, and we have to paste here the full path, the full URI path to our file, the file that we have uploaded to S3 service. We press the button and just wait until it finishes. Once we have created the workflow, we have to run it. Just mark it, select actions and run. The process may take 30 minutes, so be patient and wait until it finishes. And the next step will be to create the EC2 instance, but we have to wait to get the notification that the process has finished. Once the process has finished, we have to create a new instant EC2. So find the service as we have done before, find it EC2, select launch instance and create your own name as you want. And this is very important. Choose these options. My AMI, here is where you will find the one you have imported from the QRadar OVA that we have imported in the previous step. I recommend you to use this option, compare instances types, and filter all the instances by these three filters. At least 32 gigabytes, hypervisor Xin, the other one doesn't work with QRadar, and architecture x8664. Press select one, choose the one you want. The one that I am using now is the R4.2x large, that's my choose, you can select your own, and select the instance type. Mark these two checks, allow HTTPS traffic from the internet. Okay, these two checks should be marked in order to be able to access to the QRadar console. You have to create a new pair of keys. And you will find this page, you choose a name and download the file. Launch the instance. And that's all. Your instance has been created and it's ready to be used. In fact, it created the instance and started, so it's running. Use this option to get instructions to connect to the instance. The instance now is accessible from the internet in two ways, SSH, so you can connect and start to install QRadar, and you will be able to access to the console because Amazon will give you an IP to access to your instance. Remember to stop it when you don't use it because you are spending your money in this instance. And that's all. That's all to create the instance. Now you have to install QRadar. And according to my experience, the only thing that you have to do now is connect by SSH, login as root, and execute this script. And that's all. You don't need to do anything else. You don't need to configure IPs. You don't need to configure network. Everything will work just after the setup finish. I recommend you to use the command top to know the CPU usage. I tell you this because sometimes it looks like QRadar is not working, but if you see the top command, you see that a CPU is over 100-200% of usage, and that's the signal that you have to wait until QRadar stop doing I don't know what. So use this script to install and nothing else, and check the top command to know when QRadar is really available to be used. Today, the QRadar that you are going to install doesn't work. As it, you have to install a patch and you have to change the auto update parameters. But all this is documented in the QRadar IBM official site. So my recommendation is, first of all, install QRadar at home, learn how to install, how to the virtual machine works, and when you need to have a big instance, a big virtual machine with all the memory that you will need, then create it in the cloud here in Amazon and enjoy it.